Hello students, now let's consider the third diagenetic stage. We call it as telogenesis. If you recall from the earlier lecture, this includes reactions that happens during the upliftment of earlier formed sediments. The telogenesis include late stage diagenesis that accompanies uplift of previously buried sediment into the regime of meteoric water. So, the sediments that was buried at greater depth once is gradually uplifted to the near weathering condition or near surface condition. Sediments that are still deeply buried in sedimentary basin, consider those which are never uplifted, they do not undergo telogenetic process. Uplift and exposure of the sediment brings sediments into the telogenetic regime, which are characterized by reduction in pressure and temperature and generally having an oxidizing condition and meteoric pore waters. Mineral assemblages formed under high temperature and pressures during mesogenesis tend to become unstable under the changed conditions of the telogenesis, which means that earlier the minerals under mesogenetic regime were experiencing high temperature, high pressure and a different chemical composition of the pore fluid and mostly anoxic condition. But here when it is exposing to the telogenetic regime, you have the oxidizing conditions and presence of meteoric pore water having a different chemistry and change in the temperature and pressure regime. So the minerals that formed under mesogenetic regime tend to be unstable under the conditions of telogenesis. Telogenetic modification include dissolution of previously formed cements or framework grain, which means that the dissolution causes new pore spaces being created, or in situ alteration of framework grains into clay minerals, and that reduces the porosity. Depending upon the nature of the pore waters, silica or carbonate cements can be precipitated. Example for which is carbonate cements precipitate in the Wardous zone by evaporative pumping under the climatic condition that favor evaporation, which means under arid condition you can have the precipitation of carbonate cements in the Wardous zone. Diagenetic changes in the telogenetic stage includes oxidation and destruction of organic matter, oxidation of iron carbonates to form iron oxides and eventually hematite. So you see that here all the minerals that formed under reducing condition, they are being oxidized. Oxidation of sulfides to form sulfates such as gypsum, dissolution of pyroxenes, amphiboles and other heavy minerals during the weathering, and alteration of detrital feldspar to kaolinite happens in this telogenetic stage. The detrital feldspar are also reported to alter to illite and orthogenic potassium feldspar. Other telogenetic changes that may include alteration of chlorite to vermiculite and dissolution of iron oxides and carbonates. In this diagram, it is a flow chart illustrating the links between regimes of diagenesis. So here we discuss various regimes of diagenesis that we have explained so far and the role of structural inversion that refers to the upliftment process that causes telogenesis. So if you see on the left hand side, here you have the deposition happens in a basin, and in this regime the eogenesis happens due to the interaction of detrital assemblages with the pore waters at shallow burial and under influence of the depositional system. And these eogenetic sediments or the sediments within the eogenetic regime, they move into the mesogenetic regime by effective burial and increasing overburden thickness. In the mesogenetic regime, what happens is compaction and pore water expulsion, dehydration of clays, gypsum and organic matter decarboxylation of organic matter, then you have the petroleum generation and oil pressure buildup. So this causes mechanical and chemical compaction, interstitial waters influenced by increasing temperature and pressure, and from the products of burial reactions in adjacent and enclosing sediments, growth of cements, then destruction of primary porosity. All these changes happens due to the mesogenesis or the late diagenetic process. Now, the rock or sediments that is present in the mesogenetic stage are uplifted due to the process called structural inversion. The upliftment may happen at any time or depth or temperature during the burial period. So, the structural inversion causes the sediment to expose into the last regime of the diagenesis, or the third regime of the diagenesis called telogenesis. Here, the sediments interact with the meteoric water, usually at a shallow depth of burial. And the sediments are further again exposed to the weathering, erosion and transportation process. So this is a flowchart that explains various stages of diagenesis, that includes deposition, eogenesis, effective burial leading to mesogenesis, then structural inversion leading to telogenesis. So with this, we complete the topic on diagenesis and its various stages. Thank you.